it's actually kind of cool to be filming again, and I'm a little bit nervous. And if you hear some noises, it's probably my cat. But yes, again, welcome to my lifestyle channel. In this video, I want to talk about habits and how to actually implement successfully certain habits into your lifestyle. Last year, I started implementing certain habits that I struggled for actually years and months to implement into my lifestyle. So I started introducing them last year, and I think it was really successful. So I'd like to share my journey and my tips with you. So first of all, I want to start by talking about habits that I started introducing into my life that were extremely crucial and that I couldn't implement for months and years. So first of all is cold shower. I always wanted to do cold shower, and not just occasionally, but actually like every evening once I shower. And I've been doing that for months now. I think even like half a year maybe. So it's really amazing. I love it. And when I go to the shower, I just don't leave my shower without cold shower. The next habit is applying some face cream, and it sounds ridiculous, right? But when you're tired, when you come home after work, you wash your face, you're just like so lazy and you're like, whatever, I don't want to do that tomorrow. No, right now I do that every evening. As saying comes to my body, while with face I could understand, like, you know, everybody can see your face, of course it's important for body. I was like, whatever, you know, you wear clothes. No, now I apply creams on my body and it just like feels so good, and I just feel amazing when I do that. Every evening when I get up from the shower, I do, you know, all the things for my face, for my body. And again, it sounds silly, but I was really struggling with that. And you know, your habits don't have to be those giant things. You can just start with smaller things. So last week I actually introduced a new habit into my lifestyle. It's working out. I've been struggling with that again for years and years, but I decided, you know, finally that's the end. I have to start working out. And my goal is to work out 3 times a week, which I successfully completed last week. So now let's go to the steps that helped me. So first of all, I just want to say that it's very important to know your goal and what you actually want. Why are you implementing a new habit into your lifestyle? Do you want this new habit because someone thinks it's cool and trendy and everybody around you does that, or you do that for yourself and for your own benefit, for your health, for your brain, for your, I don't know, skin, whatever? So I think again, just think about it and write your goals down. The next step that again helps me a lot, because I'm obviously on the journey of changing my mindset, my lifestyle, and when you do that, you just want everything to happen overnight and you don't want to wake up same old you the next day. No, you want to wake up, you know, fit and healthy and positive, but it just doesn't happen like that. So I think the issue with that when people do that, they start implementing so many habits and it's just so unrealistic. So I think you just have to choose a few habits that are extremely crucial for you and that you can focus right now. So for example, if you are on a weight loss journey, you may think that you need to drink 2 liters of water, you need to eat all the healthiest foods, you need to walk, you need to jog, you need to go to a swimming pool, you need to also stretch at home, you need to meditate, and blah 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 blah. So with that list, you really want to, you know, just make it simple. And okay, you are on a weight loss journey, maybe start drinking a little bit more water, start cutting out some bad foods from your diet, start implementing a few better options into your diet, and start exercising maybe not 7 times a week, but 2 to 3 times a week. Another example would be, I want to read 100 books a year. Well, good for you, but it means that you have to read like 2 books a week. Are you sure with your schedule you're able to actually do that? Maybe instead of reading or planning to read 100 pages a day, you can minimize it to 10 pages a day. It's better than overwhelm yourself with 100 pages a day or all this, you know, new habits, and then just after a week or after a few days realizing that, okay, I cannot do that, so buy a new habit. Another habit that helps me a lot is just reminding myself that I have to do step by step. this is my mindset, and this is what I truly believe in every aspect of our lives, to be honest. It's better than just jump and never move again. If you just do step by step, day by day, you will train your mind and yourself to do things gradually. Again, you will not overwhelm yourself with all these things, because honestly, if you overwhelm yourself, you just create unnecessary stress. And for example, again, if you're changing your mindset or your lifestyle, that's like the last thing you want to do. So remind yourself step by step, write it on your wall if you have to, set a notification, like daily notification on your phone reminding you, like, okay, step by step, remember it's only one day. Step by step, little steps are better than just these huge steps, huge jumps. Overwhelming yourself is really unnecessary. And the word that I said probably so many times in this video is do not overwhelm yourself. And I just want to remind again, do not overwhelm yourself with too many expectations. You probably think, okay, if I'm on the weight loss journey, I will lose like 10 pounds within a month, and you actually lose like 3. So I think, again, it's better to focus on the journey instead of the goal. Yes, it's important to know your goals and write them down and know why you actually do that, but it's also extremely important to focus on your journey and improve yourself. You guessed it, step by step, day by day. No need to overwhelm yourself. It worked perfectly for me. And when I fail, for example, when I don't do something or I forget, I don't pressure myself, and this is actually the next step. Don't be harsh on yourself. Today you didn't read those 10 pages. Well, you know what? Tomorrow is your day off, so maybe you can read 20 or 30 instead of 10. You know, it's totally fine. It's not like if you didn't do something, your life is over. Okay, you didn't stretch today. Okay, you didn't take cold shower today. You didn't have your 2 liters of water. You didn't walk. It's totally, totally fine. But I want to say, if it's beneficial for you to have a 30 days challenge or 60 days challenge, just do that. I do that with my gratitude journal and meditation, and it's beneficial for me, but I wouldn't be able to do that with like working out or yoga as of now. So again, be realistic and do not be harsh with yourself, because again, it will just create unnecessary stress, and it's the last thing you want to do when you introduce new habits into your lifestyle. And the last thing that I want to say is use a tracker. There are so many apps on Android and iPhone, on even like laptops, that can help you to see your progress. I actually use, I think it's pronounced Dailyo, because there you can track your moods, but you can also set the goals, and this is great. It really helps you to see how far you've come and just kind of creates a visual. I also have this journal here, which is like my glow up journal. Here I track little things like taking vitamins, meditating. I write my meditations down here. I write little things like, okay, did I journal? Did I art journal? Like things like that, you know. But in Dailyo, I track still up to this day, actually, like, you know, my habits such as cold shower or applying body cream or face cream. So it really kind of creates, again, as I said, a visual for your journey, and you later on, you can kind of pat yourself on the back and say, great job. And I think it's really important, especially when you create new habits and change your lifestyle, your mindset, and your life in general. With that being said, I want to say that I have a blog which is called Wild Ray. That's my new project, and I made a blog post about the habits, so if you want to, you can go over there and just print it out, because I also made a printable, free printable, so feel free to download it and just have it by your side when you just forgot, oh my god, there is this new habit, how do I introduce it to my life. Again, as I said, this system really helped me, and I don't think I ever introduced habits successfully for a very long time into my life. I would constantly overwhelm myself, have bigger expectations, and it just never worked for me. But this system works perfectly, and again, as I said, I do believe in step-by-step system, and I think with our lives, with stress, with, you know, the current situation, I think that's one of the best things that you can do for yourself, especially when you understand that you need to make some changes. So thank you so much for watching this video, and of course don't forget to subscribe and like. And also, if you introduce some habits successfully into your lifestyle, I'd like to hear about your journey and what did you do. Comment down below if you change your life or you in process of changing your life. That would be very interesting. Thank you so much, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye. What is wrong with letting people